Everybody, all rise.
You screwed it up.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. If we screw up, it's okay. Let's just start again from the top, people.
Everybody should.
It's just funny because he practiced his line and then got it wrong.
Sorry. Shut up.
All right, everybody.
What he's gonna say is all rise.
All rise for the honorable judge, whoever. Ready? One, two, three.
All rise for the.
Jake. Come on, guys, for serious.
Okay, ready? Okay. All rise for the honorable Judge Steve.
All right. Why is there TNT on the floor?
No
honestly. Honestly, okay. Well, I probably should go around this way.
I see.
Oh, I guess I need to say something. Welcome to today's trial of Poet versus Jake.
Yeah, that's
yeah.
It. Hey, hey, I'm also here against.
Oh
you.
Yeah. He's part of the prosecution too.
Oh,
so should I like come up here then?
Yeah.
So would it be poet versus?
Oh, this is a little bit of a crowded box.
It should be.
Maybe build a bigger box.
Why are you in our box?
So it's Jake versus the people then.
Yeah.
Jake versus the people.
Hi, people. God, that's a lot of people.
Yeah. Well, you asked for this, Jake.
You did. You did. So
criminal judge, he's a criminal.
He's a criminal. Is that how we're going to start with accusations all right away?
Your Honor, may I ask a question?
Yeah.
Guilty.
Why do you have a chicken in your hand?
You're supposed to be in F1 mode. Oh, wait, we all are, but you can't see. Why do you have something in your hand? I don't know.
I don't.
Okay.
Do I? Oops. Oh, my bad. Okay, and we're done.
All right. So we're gonna go ahead. I don't know how to do a courtroom. This is my first time.
Oh well, that is
we'll be gentle.
Would the defense like to do an opening statement?
Yes, that's a great idea, defense. Opening statement. Please.
Okay, should I go up there and say something then, or what?
Yeah, Anderson D. Getz.
Okay.
You have to address the jury, I would imagine.
Jury, I am about to address you on this matter at hand.
Could you address this guy, Ridge Bob?
We all know what happened here. Jake is completely innocent. These guys are making up all this stuff with this fake evidence and blank pieces of papers and permits and everything.
We haven't presented anything yet.
I will prove without a shadow of a doubt, without evidence, because that's how confident I am in it, that these guys are wrong and they should go to jail and Jake should be awarded $10 million.
You realize this is Santa. He knows if you've been naughty or nice.
Can I
get my opening statement now?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Oh, sure.
Right. Can I object to that, or do we have to wait for you?
No, you can't object at the beginning of the.
Yeah, you can't object during opening statements.
Object during opening statements.
People of the jury, I propose.
Some of us are zombies and cats. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't be specious.
Don't discriminate.
I propose that the case of Skybridge Bob's blame falls not just on one person, but many people, and Jake is most certainly one of them, and that he's guilty.
Hey, if I can't object, you can't object.
I object to your face. How about that?
Hey, order!
Oh, well,
order.
You're making this a very convincing case, sir.
You shouldn't laugh. He's on my side.
Okay, continue.
Really?
Oh, no.
Stop it.
I conclude.
Your
what did I miss?
Me.
Hello?
Prosecution.
What? Why is High Boy in here?
What? I hear voices.
Hi, boy. You forgot to join the jury. You're late. Come join the jury.
Or don't. That's fine.
But I'm sorry. I cannot join the jury because I am biased towards Skybridge Bob. I like him.
Okay, well, then you need to be kicked out of the call.
No, come in here. We need you. We need you. We need
you. You know what? You can come sit on Skybridge Bob's side.
I don't think that works. I think the jury must be agreed with between both parties before becoming a juror.
Gosh, listen, darn it. All right. Well, my best wishes to Anderson D. Getz and his efforts.
Well, if you want to come sit on his side of the courtroom, you can. There are seats.
You
oh,
can
oh,
come
no.
and join.
It's okay. I'll be busy bribing the judge.
The
bye, guys.
Bye.
Can you move completely out of here?
Okay.
It's against you.
Your Honor, I object. I call for a mistrial. This is obviously a farce of a lawsuit, and Jake should be set free because we cannot have people randomly interrupting the proceedings like this. Come
what
on.
He said.
Well,
you're the one interrupting. The judge hasn't even asked us to present our case.
Your client has been hitting me, so I don't want to hear anything from you.
Right, right. Okay, order. Order.
Tape recorder. Sorry, I just always wanted to say that.
Okay, yes. All right. So, who's sneaking in from back there behind? Come on in. Come in. Come on in.
I object to having a hitman in the trial while it's in session. I'm just going to put my armor back on if that's all right.
It's okay. You can just like leave the courtroom if you want, Patch.
Yes,
it's okay. I sent for him.
Well, does that make it any more okay in anyone else's mind?
Yeah, it's fine.
Everything Father Christmas does is okay.
Okay, all right. So,
the children.
The prosecution, do you have any witnesses?
Yes, I would like to call.
Wait, we're the prosecution.
Get your stuff together.
Okay, well, you guys are guilty, so I considered myself to be prosecution here.
Wait a minute. Who? This would be the defense side, and this would be the prosecutor side.
See,
you're being
you.
Too technical.
I'm sorry.
Okay, how about we categorize it like this? The people who did it and the people who didn't do it.
We're the ones suing.
No, we're countersuing you.
Okay,
but we haven't sued you yet. You can't countersue us without us suing you first.
Order in the court! If I don't have some sort of witness up on this stand in 5 seconds, then this trial will be called this trial.
Patch can get up there.
Everybody gets in the box.
I call trial. I agree. Patch,
wait. Who's in the box? Like
to, juror, like get back in the witness. Jury thing.
Who's in the box?
I'd like to call my first witness.
Okay.
I'll just take them all out at once. Can I have Dave, Jake, and Patch all in the witnesses box at once?
Wait a second.
One of the jurors is a witness?
This doesn't compromise my position as a juror.
No, of course not.
You know.
All right. So I have...
Do we really all have to be in this box
before
at the same
anyone
time?
Says anything, I have to... They have to give their pledge that they're going to say the truth.
That's true.
Of course.
Do you all swear to say the truth and nothing but the truth so help you God?
Oh, on that piece of chicken, I pledge my life.
I don't want to be in a box with these people.
The judge hit me.
Well, you deserved it.
Mistrial.
Here's a flower.
Okay.
All right.
We're good.
Go ahead, Ice.
My first piece of evidence is a letter to Poet, and I'll read aloud. Dear Mr. Poet Plays, as your bank manager and as your friend, unfortunately, it appears you have hired a dodgy contractor named XDJake123. He is a notorious cowboy builder and has hit numerous people in the area. There was a problem with a few pieces of paperwork, or to put it better, lack of paperwork. The builder's permit he sent us was simply a photocopy of a previous one, which he crossed out Patch's name and wrote his in crayon. Unfortunately, the land you claimed has been repossessed and bought by a man named Robert, or as he insists on being called, Skybridge Bob. And if you wish to reacquire the land, you must speak to him. Apparently, you can make an appointment in the RV. Goodbye. Signed, The Dave.
I knew that would come back to bite us.
Now,
who just left the courtroom?
Patch just left.
See you guys.
Go get him, Remco.
That's why Remco's here.
If all of the witnesses for the prosecution may go outside and be murdered by Remco, I would allow that.
I was going to get some evidence.
You can't just do that in the middle of a court case.
Well, I didn't have an ender chest.
Well, you know what? If we have ourselves a recreation, what is it called?
Recess.
Recess. If we have a recess, then you
a
can pee-pee go get
break.
Stuff.
Can I finish my first statement?
Yeah, he's not even finished his questioning.
Patch, I need you back in here.
I'm working on it. I'm in
Remco,
Jake's house.
Kill him.
Is it a nice house?
It's a terrible house.
Well,
except
it was decorated by
Bond,
so you're just insulting him.
I said except
it's just
for
broken
the
into someone's house.
The exterior sucks.
Wait, what side is he on?
What?
I'm on Poet's side.
Patch, you look different.
Mog? What?
Your Honor, I'd like to present my witness.
You can't present until we're done.
Oh, well, hurry up. Come on.
We still need Patch.
I'm so confused. What is everybody doing down here? Okay.
I'm just going to proceed without Patch.
Yeah, proceed without Patch.
The second
he's busy breaking and entering.
Piece of evidence is entitled Inconspicuous.
Uh-oh.
Hey, Jake. It reads,
that was a tough word to spell, Jake.
Everything seems to be going according to plan. Great job tricking Poet into signing the faulty documents. Couldn't have claimed that land without you. I'll send your payment as per agreed. Feel free to keep Poet's payment too, as a bonus. I look forward to employing your services again in the future. I think Poet is still none the wiser. I'll meet with you and Patch soon. Don't breathe a word of this to anyone, or there will be consequences. Signed, The Dave.
Your Honor, I object. He turned into a robot halfway through that.
Can the jury see these evidence pieces?
Yes, actually, the jury doesn't. Evidence pieces.
Wait, I don't believe jury gets to see evidence.
The judge gets to see the evidence. Bailiff, you're supposed to give it to me so I can
get the bailiff.
I don't want it. I don't want this.
I'm watching you, Cube.
I don't. There you go. There you go. Give those to me, bailiff.
I'm back.
Bring him around here, bailiff.
You got.
You can't see. There we go.
Bring him back. Bring him around here.
Ready?
Yes.
Some strange stuff going on over here.
This is the worst trial in the world.
Oh, why don't
Patch, get in there. You're being...
Yeah, Patch, you're supposed to be questioned.
Am I being questioned? I'm on your side.
Because your name was directly in that piece of evidence.
Yes, let's see.
Yeah. Can we maybe build another box on our side,
just
huh?
Just in here, Patch. It's fine.
Who signed this book exactly?
The Dave.
The Dave signed both of these?
Skybridge Bob, dun dun dun.
Interesting, Dave. All right, you can have your evidence back. There we go.
I have more evidence when this is done.
Thank you, Mr. Cube. Mr. Cube, any more questions for your three participants here?
I'm going to rest this for right now.
Okay. Mr. Gates, do you have?
Well, I'm going to put it away. I'm so sorry. I hit the wrong button. I meant to do this.
He punched Poet's his clock.
There you go. You can rest. There you go.
Thank you.
Behind you guys. That is the joke.
Yeah. So I'd like to question these witnesses here.
Cross-examine.
Yes, I would cross-examine them. Get Jake. Get back at the thing.
I'm sleepy. Jake.
Okay, Dave. Is it true that you did not really write those documents and they were forged by Ice Cube to try to frame you?
Wait. Yes.
Yes. See.
Wait. Now Jake. I want to remind you, Dave. You've sworn to tell the truth.
I don't remember doing
remember,
that.
You're Santa Claus. You don't have to follow those oaths.
You sit on a throne of lies.
Okay. Continue.
Okay, Jake. Is it true the thing I said to Dave about you as well?
Yeah. Sure.
Okay. Patch.
I want the truth.
You can't handle the truth.
That's just true that you're guilty.
That was funny.
I'm not guilty. I'm the ones with Poet suing them.
Remember, you swore an oath.
He is your oath denying the fact that he is not guilty, or is guilty, or one of the other.
He lied on the chicken.
Yes.
I'm not guilty. I'm one of the accusers.
Yeah.
I'm a juror.
When will the lies stop?
Who smelt it, dealt it. That's all I have to say.
You rest your
case. Honor, I rest my case. Good night. Oh, it's data.
Well, that was certainly worth it.
Okay. Who's your next witness there, Ice Cube?
Can we leave?
Well.
Yes, you may sit.
I would like to keep Dave. The Dave.
I'll stay.
So, Dave, you have told the people of the jury that you did not sign these documents.
Sorry.
No, I did not.
That these were forged by me, actually, was the actual
they were forged by you.
That at least a third of the jury agrees with me.
Poet, do you have the other piece of evidence that you might have taken?
This one?
Yes, that's it. Perfect.
Jake,
what?
Get back in here.
I forgot you were looking that way.
Oops. Now,
Remco, next time he goes out, you need to smack him with a sword.
Yeah,
he nods.
Now, I've taken this to an unauthorized signature examiner, and it does appear that your name was actually signed here by you. It says it actually right under the description of the book. So would you care to explain to us how that happened?
Well, yes. It was my book, you see, that I rented from the library. And I had simply signed my name to say that this is the book I have rented. I don't know how it could have fallen into the silent hands of Skybridge Bob. But maybe he also uses the same library as me.
What library do you use?
I'm going to address this case.
Wait, this server has a library?
Oops. Yeah.
It does?
Mog swarms. Oh, I just gave away. Sorry.
He's guilty.
Yes, I was using Mog Swarms library.
What was the name of the book? If you rented it out.
Oh, wait, are you supposed to be questioning? You need to whisper that yeah, this question in your lawyer's ear.
Over here. I'm over here.
I don't have to answer that question.
Okay. Ask him what the name of the book was.
So, the Dave, if you say you rented this book from the library, what are the names of these books?
Well, one of them has quite an embarrassing title. Do I have to say it, Judge?
Yes. Jack Connor, he should not have to say it. This is
overruled.
10 reasons why size doesn't matter.
Order. Order.
Yeah, order in the court, even in the judge, too. Order. There we go. It's not funny. It's okay, buddy. We all have that problem.
And the other one?
Sure, we do.
3 unconventional uses for glowstone.
Oh, okay.
I don't really want to know what said reasons are.
I would like the judge to examine these books.
Where?
Ask him how he can explain the contents of the book.
I don't think that's necessary.
Yes, it is! They're not books from the library!
What, if you care to share with us, are the contents of these books?
Were the titles not descriptive enough?
Not enough, no, not enough.
I cannot remember the contents.
He cannot remember. He cannot remember.
Likely story, Judge.
Judge, I would like you to examine these books once again and tell the people whether or not those are truly the titles of
There's
these
some
two
graphic
books.
Pictures, I warn you.
Okay, let's see. Now, do we have a black bar available just in case? Okay, just asking. All right, let's see. This one is titled...
Use Huck's monobrow.
This is inconspicuous and urgent. Well, I'll admit that first book that you mentioned is inconspicuous. It's pretty inconspicuous. And when the other one was Glowstone, that's kind of urgent. But that is not the title of either one of these books.
Oh.
Your Honor, I object. In England, they use different terms for things that you will not understand.
Gotcha.
Is it an English book?
All right. You can go ahead and take these back here.
I would object to that. He is Welsh, not English.
Yes. Oh, I object to that, too.
Yeah, okay.
Is that enough cause for a mistrial?
Yeah, can we get a mistrial?
Hey, no. Let's continue on with this.
Okay. Can I cross-examine him?
Yes.
I would
any
like
more questions,
to represent myself next because you guys are all bumbling idiots.
You have no more questions, Dice?
I have no more questions.
Okay, you can go ahead and cross-examine, Mr. Gett.
Okay. The Dave. Is it true that this time of year is a very busy time for you with the holidays and everything?
Oh, yes, very busy.
Yes. And so may you be likely to forget how some events may have went down?
Yes.
Yes. And so... Is Poet wrong in saying and insinuating that you are lying by saying that your story is likely not remembering the details?
Yes.
Okay. And did you really rent those books from the library? Someone, you signed your name, someone stole
hold
them,
it, hold
whited
it.
Out all the page,
stop,
and
stop,
rewrote
stop,
it.
Stop.
Did
come
that
over
happen?
Here. This.
What?
Who
put that there?
Remco.
Jake, empty your inventory now.
Mistrial.
It was Jake.
What?
I saw him do it.
Jake, you are under arrest for trying to blow up the...
No, I'm not.
Ow.
You're in contempt.
Ow.
Hey, order! if I have one more address from you, Jake, I'm gonna have Rimco take his last slice to your throat.
Oh, God.
Your Honor, I object to this treatment of my client here, and I call for a mistrial on the grounds of his life being endangered.
Mr. Getz, where did this come from?
Where did what come from? This?
On the floor. Yeah, where did that come from?
This came from a very special place that I cannot
Your
imagine.
Client's back pocket.
Look at his hand.
What?
How do I change it? Go hide that. No, he did not ever have TNT on his person.
So, where did he get it?
oh from you, God. Probably. When you left the room, you planted it on him when no one was paying attention.
Jake is not the one in the witness box.
Okay, you're right. Dave wants to be cross-examined more. Go ahead.
Oh, okay.
I love being examined.
Is it true that you would like to be cross-examined more?
Yes.
See, okay. Your Honor, I rest my case. I present this witness.
Okay. So, did you have another witness to call up?
You may
sit down, buddy. You may go.
I would like to request permission to represent myself because these guys are bumbling idiots.
That's rather
rude. Excuse me. I agree. Jake.
What?
Jake. I would like to call Jake to the stand.
Okay.
Remember to lie, Jake.
What? Seriously? You had to use an intro to get over there.
I can't jump. My leg hurts because Paulette hurt me.
Oh.
So slamming yourself into a wall is a better.
Yes, Bond.
Oh yeah, that part of him didn't hurt before he did it.
Bond, it was his leg.
I see.
That was just a discussion among the jurors.
Okay, Ice, questions?
So, Jake, in this document, signed...
Sit down, Santa.
I can't see.
I can't.
Signed by the Dave, tells us that you... tricked Poet into signing the faulty documents. Would you like to explain that?
Well, you see, it was a misconception. I didn't trick him. He willingly signed the document. Yeah, I tricked him.
Sounds like a confession.
Did you just say yes, he tricked me?
Yeah, I did. But what? I'm not guilty. Because overall, he agreed to
you
me.
Just admitted to the crime and said you weren't guilty.
No, I didn't trick him into signing the documents. I tricked him into thinking he was tricked into signing the tricked documents.
Why would you do that?
Because it was funny.
The Dave also tells us in a letter to Poet that you crossed out Patch's name and wrote his name in with crayon. How would you like to explain that?
Crayon.
It's crammed.
It's British. A business card.
What?
What?
What sort of business is this, Jake?
It is the business where I create decorative business cards that look like they have a name on them crossed out. In crayon.
I never ordered any business cards. Why was I even involved?
Why would you write them over my name?
Yeah.
Okay, listen, Ice, you're gonna have to keep your clients hush hush.
Then tell us, Jake, why you would cross out Patch's name.
Because he killed me.
What?
What else do you want? That answered the question.
But you're saying that you did
know how it
Patch's
works
name.
That if I killed you, sorry.
Yes or no questions. Yes or no questions.
What was the question?
I feel
so
like I've
then
seen
you admit
enough.
To crossing out Patch's name on the document.
Who's Patch?
I'm actually kind of curious if this client has a mental disease.
Whoa!
I object. There's fire, mistrial.
Bailiff
threw that before.
Your client lit the fire.
What happened?
Judge, it was this person right here.
Can you prove that?
That started.
I see it. Are you questioning?
He's not under oath. How do we know he's telling the truth?
Are you questioning justice? Ow, he's hitting me.
Alright, okay.
Your Honor, I object to the abuse of my client here.
Okay. Ice, do you have some more questions?
I think I'm done questioning Jake.
Okay, would you like to cross-examine your...
Yes,
your...
I sure would. Jake, is it true that by trick, when you said that you tricked him into signing it, it was actually a false document that, yes, was a trick, but was for Halloween, and the real document was completely legitimate, but these guys over here disposed of it so that it would incriminate you?
That is exactly
Judge,
what happened.
Judge, this was no treat. It was definitely a trick.
Exactly, in the spirit of Halloween.
That was exactly and what happened.
Yes, it was all
I
good fun.
It
written
using
months
British
before
slang.
Halloween.
It happened way before Halloween.
You
yeah.
can't prove
well,
that.
Well, in other countries, Halloween's in other months, so...
What countries?
Now, if you hang on, are you sure it wasn't Thanksgiving? Because that's the truth.
Steve, I think you're a little biased on this.
On Halloween versus Thanksgiving?
But, yeah, you're like helping him prove a point.
Oh, I'm sorry. I apologize. As a judge, I should not have done that.
Remember,
I
apologize for
it's
telling you how wrong
yourself.
You are, Your Honor.
Well, if anyone here would know about holidays, it is Dave. And I'm sure he would agree with me.
He's a witness. He's in the jurors box. He can't chime in as a witness. You had your chance to cross-examine him, and you didn't.
I did. I cross-examined him.
He did.
Yes.
I enjoyed it.
Okay. Jake, is it true that the crayon mentioned... Oh, wait. Hold on. I need to actually have the mic here for a little bit. Is it true that the crayon mentioned was just a playful drawing of Poet that you... did for him as a gift
Dang,
for Halloween.
He's a serial killer for cats.
Just kill a cat.
He did.
Your Honor, I call
hey,
for
Jared, hey,
you
order.
Monster.
Order. Jake, did you just hit me?
He killed a cat.
Of course not.
There was two cats here. Now there's only one, and it's
He's
all
taking out the jury.
Oops.
Okay, all right, order in the court. Back to places. Let's go.
Santa is an anagram for Satan.
All right, Mr. Getz, continue. Is that,
okay.
Wait, first, Honor. Hang on. Mr. Getz, is that a very bad toupee you're wearing there?
No, that is not, and I am not in question here. I'm not under oath. I do not need to answer that question.
Chicken?
Okay, all right. I've continue with your cross-examination.
Okay. Jake, is it true that this case, this whole courtroom, everything here, these proceedings are a complete farce and the judge should just agree to a mistrial?
Complete farcity. Mistrial is needed.
There we go. I rest my witness. Go to bed, Jake.
Oh, the bed's gone.
All right, Ice, do you have another witness?
Oh, God.
Oh, destroying dang on government property over there, Jake.
I'd like to call Patch to the stand.
Ooh. Hold on. In light of the fact that everyone is killing everyone, I'd like to make this area a little more safe.
And Bailiff,
so
have,
I'm just going to be putting a wall around myself.
Bailiff, make sure that you square him in.
I will.
He's already been sworn in.
Hey!
I can't see you.
I'm making myself more safe.
You're okay. Safe. I'm right next to you. Just get in the chair.
Okay.
This is why we have a guy in armor.
Now, do you swear to tell the truth, nothing but the truth?
Do I have to repeat?
Oh no!
Oh!
Do you swear to tell the whole truth and nothing but the truth, so help you, Skybridge Bob?
I hope that's not burning
his house down. Wait,
you think that's a setup right there?
I swear to tell the truth. The whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
Except...
Did that work?
Are you good? Good to go.
All right.
Like that.
So, now that you've been sworn in twice, tell me, Patch, when the Dave signed this document, including... Is everything okay?
Yeah, we're good.
That included...
Jake! No! What is this?
I call for a mistrial.
I agree. Your Honor, I agree. Mistrial.
The judge just left his bench to punch Jake.
He has that right.
Exactly.
Discipline it.
Jake has suffered enough abuse in this case and false accusations.
Bailiff should be doing this stuff.
We need to hear what Patch has to say.
Get in your spot. Get. Stay.
First of all, I'd like to get this stupid microphone out of my face.
Okay. I call for a mistrial.
Is it true that when the Dave signed this incriminating document, that he included your name to try to spread the blame?
Let me tell you what happened from my perspective. In February of...
Answer the question, Pat.
I am.
Order,
this is a,
Jake.
This is
one more
hours
like that and you will be thrown out of this courtroom.
Can we just throw him out now?
No.
No.
The
well,
case
shot
will go on without you, Jake.
Anyways.
And guess who will win in that case?
Yes.
In February of 2013, Poet commissioned me to build a record farm for his house, and I did not specify a time limit, which means that I am able to do it whenever I please.
It's
Jake,
sadly
however,
true. It's sadly true.
Jake, however, decided that his services would be much better than mine and decided to create incriminating documents against me and take permits illegally from the town mayor with the town mayor's permission that would allow him to do anything that he wanted. I have said building permits right here.
Wouldn't that
Your
make
Honor,
it legal?
I object. How could it be illegal if it was with the permission of the mayor?
They bribed him.
Do you have any proof of that?
I have
Which
video evidence of that.
I knew we shouldn't record that.
Well, it's not my video evidence. It's their video evidence. They recorded the whole event.
Exactly.
And
we
by they,
it.
I mean Jake and Dave.
Now, wait a second. What's this Jake 1, Jake 2 nonsense?
A document that the mayor of this town signed proved
okay
that he would be able to build anywhere. Fortunately, I was able to get said permits repealed, but Jake has been out to get me ever since. My name is on the document that you have, Mr. Ice Cube, because Jake was trying to create false incriminating evidence to get back at me for the whole... for my canceling the building project, for me canceling the building permits, and if you need any more proof that this man is,
quite a flammable courthouse you have here, poet.
If you need any more proof that this man is guilty, he keeps trying to burn down the courthouse. I rest
it's,
my
it's
case.
It's the flammable house above the flammable courthouse.
You can't rest your case. You're a witness.
I rest my witnessing.
You can't rest your witnessing. You have to keep going until he says you can stop.
Okay. Ask me another question.
So, this incriminating evidence by the Dave, not Jake, includes your name to spread the blame, right?
I hear, Bernie.
I have no idea why my name is on a document by the Dave, other than the fact that the Dave and the Jake are business partners. And
who's
I
the
believe
Jake?
The Dave and Jake are business partners, and I believe, yes, it was, in effect, a way to spread the blame.
All right, I will rest my case there.
Can I rest my witnessing?
No, you
no,
can't. I have
no,
a question
you cross-examined.
Oh. Okay, is it true that you said you have no idea how your name was on that paper, right?
I just said that it was on there because... The Dave.
He said you. I object. He said he had no idea why his name would be on a paper with the Dave and Jake.
If not for the fact that they were trying to incriminate
you
me by
yes
spreading the blame.
A life was an attempt at the
so,
life of the judge was just made.
George Washington was almost assassinated here.
Let's hang on a second. Let's follow this arrow and see which way it came from. That general direction.
Could have been me. I'm over here.
That could have been everyone in
it's
the room.
Rem.
Your Honor, I call for a mistrial here.
Okay, there's not going to be a mistrial.
Oh, okay. Well,
am
can,
I done
can
yet?
I proceed with my questioning without
yes
without these interruptions?
All right, this is
it's
seriously
your
getting on my
that's
nerves.
Interrupting.
Is it true? Okay, you did say that you have no idea how your name was on that paper. So
I said that, I have no idea what my name. You're taking things out of context, Mr. D. Getz.
That is what lawyers do.
Amen.
So
I said I have no idea why my name is on that paper, if not for the fact that they are trying to spread the blame and incriminate me with poet.
Exactly. Okay, so you're saying that they doctored the original document to make it look like your name was on it, although the evidence shows that they crossed out your name and put... wait, what name did they put on it?
Your client's name.
Okay, yes, Jake put his own name on there. So if the original document was doctored, how could it be doctored a second time, and thus the whole thing is false and
I object.
It was doctored this twice? Case out.
It was doctored a second time in an attempt for Jake to cover up what he had done.
I object.
But he admitted, Jake admitted to crossing out your name and putting his name on it, but you
so
said
my point
your
is
name was an original
true.
On it, so it was never an official document to begin with. So, I call for
I object.
What's your objection
object.
There, Ice Cube?
Well, this piece of incriminating evidence is not the document in which his name was crossed out. This is just simply a letter from the Dave to Jake, including Patch, in it.
Ice Cube seems much more prepared than Mr. Getz.
Ice Cube has better hair than Mr. D.
Jake or Dave.
Your Honor, I object. How come I don't have any documents?
Yeah, you can pour open a mic. Oh.
Ooh, oh, here's one for you. Here's one for you.
Yeah, you can have that too.
Yeah, no. Yeah, the
oh, you
paper
can have
is...
the one that's on that sign right there.
Okay, continue with the trial, please.
So,
can I go now?
Yeah. Well, I just want to say, he admits that his name was doctored on the first time, so the second doctoring was just a doctoring of the original doctoring, and thus, Jake is not guilty. I rest
he doctored
my
them
witness.
Both times. He
nope.
admitted to
Your Honor, it. Tell him to shut up. I object.
You're able to step down off the bench.
Thank you, Bailiff.
He objects to his own cross.
Why would you take that?
He put it there.
Why would I take what?
I know, but why wouldn't you just leave it there so everybody else can see higher, too? That's all right.
But it's my chair.
Behind you, poet! Okay, all right.
He just smacked his lawyer.
I had to in the all name right. of firefighting.
Ice Cube, do you have
all
any
right,
more witnesses?
I will...
We rest our case.
That was only one side of the story, though.
There is a lot
Your
more
Honor?
To the story, I believe.
Okay. Your Honor, I'd like to call to the stands as a surprise witness, Adulgit.
He's not in the courtroom.
He is.
Okay.
He's also not in the case.
As the second surprise witness, I would like to call to the stand that zombie over there.
How are we supposed
fraternizing
to do
that?
That zombie is a free spirit, and he does what he wants.
Hey, stop hurting
Don't release him. He will exact his vengeance.
Hey!
Whoa!
They are trying to murder the witness.
Wait a second. Judge, you did something.
Wait, water,
this is
water.
Out of hand.
Water. Water!
He's fine.
Oh no, the cattle's fine.
Order in the court!
Ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, Your Honor, okay.
I believe that I have located something. In my attempt to run for water, I would like you to all to come and take a look at the contents of this chest.
Oh, the zombie just died too. I wonder how. Oh.
There was a bucket in there, but there was also plenty of TNT. And Jake is holding TNT in his hand!
You can't prove that.
There's no TNT in there, Your Honor.
That's circumstantial evidence.
Yes, that means that has nothing to do with the
Yes,
yes.
It really does have
nothing to do with
the evidence.
Not in the
courtroom.
Back to the courtroom. May I call a witness to the stand, finally, or do you want to call the
witness? Yeah, we're gonna go. Get them all back in here.
Who are you?
What?
Your Honor, I would like to call
I got bored of being a witness, so I'd like to be a juror.
Well,
Huck, the bailiff.
Two of four have died, so.
What?
Huck, the bailiff, go to the stand.
Great.
Ow.
Okay.
Your Honor, I call for a mistrial. I set myself on fire.
Okay, go ahead, Mr. Getz.
Okay. Mr. Huck, the bailiff, is it true that all you want to do is play on the red cubed?
Yes, it's true, okay? It's
Jake.
True. All Jake. I want to do is play on the red cube.
Okay, I rest my case, Your Honor.
Okay, cross-examination?
Pass.
Okay, you may go to your corner. All right, Mr. Getz, anybody else that you'd like to call?
I would like to call to the stand. I don't know.
Do we need to call him?
Poet.
What? Oh, okay, good idea. Your Honor, I would like to call to the stand Mr. Poet.
Mr. Blaze.
Mr. Endo.
Endo.
Poet, do you swear to tell the truth and nothing but the truth to help you, God?
Yeah, sure.
Poet, is it true? Hey, nope, I'm trying to talk here. Is it true that you're a Canadian?
Yep.
Okay. Interesting answer there.
I thought he was about Guilty. To walk away.
Is it true that you are wearing goggles now to try to hide that you're lying?
Nope.
Okay. Interesting response there. A typical response, Your Honor. Okay. Is it true that those gold boots were purchased with the money that was laundered with this whole farce of a lawsuit that you put together with Ice Cube, and you're completely guilty 100%, and this should be a mistrial?
Lawsuits cost you money. They don't give you money.
Not if you launder the money somehow. I read that.
I don't like doing laundry.
Your Honor, I object. He smells. His laundry has been done for weeks.
That proves that I don't like doing laundry, and therefore...
And therefore, the stink of guilt is all over you. I rest my case.
All right, so, Mr. Cube.
Yes, I would love to.
Okay.
I'd love to cross-exam. So, Mr. Poet, please. Not Poetendo. Is it true that Skybridge Bob has already started encroaching on your property? No, that was the bailiff.
Oh.
Why does Steve have TNT in his hand?
Because I picked it up off the ground because Jake put it there. Jake, I saw that.
He didn't. Ow, who shot me?
I think I just prevented the assassination of Steve.
Your Honor, I didn't hear the question. I'd like my lawyer to repeat it.
Is it true that Skybridge Bob has already started to build upon your property?
Yeah, you better believe he has. From the very first day that the record farm was going to be built, Patch was going to build me a record farm, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, comes a fire.
Objection, Remco.
Whoa!
Oh, Your Honor, I object.
Object to what?
Escape. Oh, there's nothing there.
There's still fire burning. Going. Burning is underneath here.
Can I just hide it?
Jake! Oh God, the humanity!
Oopsie.
Put it out!
Look at
Your Honor, I object to that death message.
Look at all of the TNT he had on
my
his person.
My client was murdered in the court.
He deserved it.
I
think the jury has seen enough to make a verdict, to be honest.
What's this down here?
I think the jury's half dead.
Yeah, the jury is half dead, which is...
The judge also was killed in battle.
Ladies and gentlemen of the remaining jury.
Yeah.
Come take a look at this.
That doesn't prove anything.
And where?
This proves nothing.
What is this?
It doesn't prove anything.
Proof that Jake has been hiding a secret base to make his escape.
What makes you think Jake built that?
Whoa.
Because he told me he built it.
Yeah,
are you taking
he told me
told
he
you.
Would plan his escape through a secret base.
Dave, are you taking offense that somebody else is getting credit for your work?
I didn't build that.
Oh, okay.
Hey, I'm still on the stand.
Wait, there's a sign here you guys missed.
Hey!
You guys missed. No. You've missed the sign down here.
What does the sign say?
It says Jake's place.
Oh, does it?
Your Honor, I object to that. That anyone could have wrote that.
Yeah, okay. Like Jake.
All right.
Well, anyone except for Jake could have wrote that.
Now, are you finished with Ice Cube? Are you finished with Poet?
I'm not.
Okay.
I didn't even get to finish answering that first question.
We order in the court.
How convenient.
Get back to your seats.
I need to take a recess because Jake is dead.
He doesn't need not to be here.
Your Honor, my client is dead. Mistrial.
I return.
Okay, go ahead.
Right, is it also true that
Remco confiscated it, I believe?
Thank you, Remco.
Oh, I'm not going to challenge that guy.
Your Honor, I feel my juror has lost his mind.
All right, Mr. Cube, order the court, please.
All right,
Mr.
Please,
Cube, continue.
Please. Jake. Is it also true that there has started to have a build site for the Skybridge Bob headquarters?
Yeah.
Yes.
It was written in Dave's writing, I think.
And is it
Your
also
Honor,
true?
Your Honor, that is circumstantial. Minecraft uses the same font for everything.
Yes, exactly.
Is it true, though, that in that dig site, that they have found some fairly valuable things?
Yeah, iron and gold.
Piles
of it.
Like the
loads
gold you use to make your booties?
Piles of iron and gold found on Poet's Land
what
in a place...
What booties, Dave? What booties?
Dave has TNT.
Do I?
Your Honor, I object. You're wearing matching capes with the plaintiff. That's...
And the judge.
That's bias.
They're in cahoots.
Oh,
I think some sort of conspiracy club.
I think that the jury can obviously tell what the purpose of that dig site was, and it was not specifically for a Skybridge Bob headquarters, but instead to profit off the land owned by Mr. Endo.
Yeah, they wanted the land because it was worth a lot of money.
That is all.
All right. That's it? Now, Mr. Guest, did you get a chance to question Mr.
Yeah,
Poet?
I called the stand.
Okay, great, great. You have any more? You may step down, Mr. Poet.
Call Steve.
Okay.
So I believe we are ready for closing arguments here.
Oh, right,
call
Cliff.
Me.
Oh.
Wait.
Ice Cube just attempted to kill the bailiff.
Objection.
Okay, all right, listen. Do you have any more people to call to the stand, Mr. Getz?
No, I do not. I'm ready to rest my case.
All right. In that case, we'll start with the closing arguments, and Mr. Getz, you can go ahead.
Okay. I think it is fairly certain that these people here, with their gold booties,
diamond,
trying to hide, and this guy in his armor and his diamond. Look at this. Okay. If anyone profited from that land, it was these three here. My client.
It was my land. I have a right to profit from my
Your
land.
Client is wearing full diamond armor.
Take that armor off.
He's just murdered.
The most fancy suit.
You're okay. As I was saying, if anyone profited off of this land, yes, it was them, and it was their land. But they are trying to frame Jake and sue him for what he owns, saying that he took their land, which he did not. And if anyone here in this courtroom knows who's been naughty and who's been nice, I believe it's Dave over here. And he will agree that you three are guilty. And my little defendant here, who has been bullied mercilessly.
Get the courtroom on fire.
Your Honor, I object. He did not do that. I did that. I mean, we don't know who did that.
Interesting.
All right. Would
and
you like?
You were hired by him, am I right?
Hey, I'm not under oath. I don't need to answer your questions, Diamond Boot guy.
Mr. Your Honor, do you think that he should answer our questions?
You don't have a right to approach the bench.
Yeah, exactly. Yes. You're gonna have to go sit down there,
Patch.
I'm sorry.
Question a lawyer part of our team.
Mr. Cube, would you like to go ahead and give us your closing arguments?
All right, my closing statement: Jake is guilty.
No, I'm not.
That's it.
I object.
Hashtag ban.
Can't object to closing statements.
Okay.
Watch.
All right. So we're going to go ahead and have a quick recess while the jury gets together and discusses.
Deliberates.
Deliberates. That's the word we were looking for. Deliberates the trial here and comes up with our what's going to happen. So let's go ahead and hit that recess button.
do we have a
jury? All rise for the Honorable Judge Steve.
Steve is a bad judge name.
Elemento, maybe? I don't know. Whatever. All right.
The Elemento judge.
That's right. Exactly. So, jury, have you finished deliberating?
Yes, sort of. We have.
All right. Go ahead and get that for me, bailiff.
Or is it not in my hand? I'm in F1. I'm sorry. Got it.
Got it.
Okay.
Can I ask Poet to get off the desk?
I needed Thank to you. Get a good view.
All right.
Well, I didn't really want to see that part of you, Poet.
Okay. All right. Order. Okay. Now.
Oh, I see it.
What do you...
Stay where you're at.
Yes. Stay there. Before we give you the jury's deliberation, I wanted to say a couple of things. I found that this trial had very many holes in it. It's quite ridiculous. It was outrageous. There was people doing things they never should do in a courtroom ever. Yes, Jake, I'm talking to you. And I'm very surprised with the holes in this trial. I'm very surprised that you were even able to come up with a decision. But you did.
Holes in the courtroom.
Holes in the courtroom. Those two. But
holes.
You did. And because you did, I must read off this verdict.
I'm having crazy deja vu right now. I don't know about you guys.
So, the jury has found, in the case of the people versus Jake, they have found Jake to be guilty.
Dun, dun.
What?
Dun.
No!
Jake!
Jake.
No! What? No!
Wait, he's getting Jake. Away!
All I want to do is play a Minecraft. All I want to do is play with my friends. My friends and me found me guilty in the lamest stupid trial that you ever did see. Yeah. All I want to do is blow up the red cube. All I want to do is blow up the red cube. All I want to do is blow up the red cube. Come along and see my friend explosions here that never end. I'm out here having fun here on the red cube server.